I have seen family members, grandparents, my husband's father pass away in palliative. And to me, palliative was end of life. You have hours to live. Get you down to palliative in the hospital. For me, I was diagnosed stage 4. And in the same breath, I had so many back issues. And what I learned was that I had a compression fracture in my lower spine. So that would explain it. So I said that to my oncologist. So we talked on the phone, and I knew things weren't good. And then going in, we got the final diagnosis, chit-chatted a little back and forth. And I said, my back, like I need something, my back. And I'm not one to take medication. Like I don't love medication. But I said, I need something, this is ridiculous. And she said, I'll send you to pain management. Can you be in here tomorrow at 9 a.m.? Yep, great. So I show up by myself because I know we're just going to talk about my pain. And so the doctor walks in and she puts her hand out and she said, I'm Dr. So-and-so, welcome to palliative. Whoa, I'm not here for palliative, I'm here for pain management. I couldn't tell you what was said in that appointment. I have no idea. I just kept thinking, I'm in palliative. There's something they're not telling me. There's something my oncologist has withheld from me because the word palliative was never mentioned to me. And so what I learned very quickly is that what it actually means is when you have a life-threatening illness, it's a way of supporting you through your illness. It could be 20 years. But palliative is actually a very good thing. But to me, palliative meant hours to live. I didn't understand the difference between palliative and hospice. I didn't understand that palliative was more than just end of life, not even resources, but end of life, like a morphine pump. I think that's kind of synonymous with palliative. And then what I learned was that it's so much more, it's about spiritual, psychosocial, sexual, pain management. It's such a huge umbrella that I wish that A, my oncologist maybe would have given me a heads up, and B, that we would just demystify this. I talk about palliative all the time. I've been palliative almost 3 years. Well, that's not the regular assumption or definition of what palliative is. And many of us haven't experienced palliative that way. Like I said, I feel that a lot of us have watched loved ones die in palliative, but I wish that even hospice, I go to a hospice day program and I had no concept that was actually like, if you're going in for a hospice day program, you're not leaving. Well, it's actually me with a whole bunch of, they're all older because it's either that or nothing. But it was just me with people who get it, and we paint and I get my feet rubbed sometimes, like reflexology. We have a lovely meal together. It's so much different. Hospice residence is much different. That's end of life, probably your last week or so. But this, the definition of palliative is so much different than what I think the average Canadian may feel. My palliative team is so wonderful. If I am missing anything, a referral, let's say, in that appointment, like within an hour of leaving the hospital, I have a phone call. Like they don't just do, oh, you have pain, here's a prescription. They want to know about, we've talked about anything from DNR to psychosocial support to my pain to often they just, like my appointments with palliative are often like an hour long and they just want to know, how are you doing? So my oncologist deals with my cancer, palliative deals with kind of head to toe, anything from pain to, sometimes it's a cancer, often they've taken the time to explain a scan to me, so they'll pull it right up for me and say, okay, whatever it is, here's the fracture or here's the pain, and then how can we help with that? Or if I come to them and say, this is a resource, yep, we'll refer you. They are wonderful, and I had absolutely no idea. To me, the palliative ward in the hospital was palliative. That's all it was. And you are often unconscious and bring in the family, she's in palliative. And that is what it means sometimes. But the majority of time when you are referred to palliative, the situation isn't great, but being referred to palliative doesn't affect the situation. It is what it is. Your diagnosis is what it is. So why not sign on to something that is only going to help you.